Welcome back to Kings Lab IT Consult. In this video, we're going to be talking about DACP and then Windows Deployment Services. So let's go ahead and launch our server. So I have my server already launched. So I'm just going to click on input. As we said, you go to keyboard and then you can click on insert control delete, select your account, and then you can log in. So in the previous video, we spoke about Active Directory Domain Services as well as DNS. So it's a follow-up video. So today we'll be talking about Windows Deployment Services as well as DACP. So what we are doing here, when we talk about DACP, what we are trying to say is it stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. And the motive of Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol is to assign or give out or lease out IP addresses to client computers automatically. So that's what it does. So the motive of desktop or enterprise business desktop is to be able to deploy operating system on more than what a lot of computers within a shorter period of time without using a CD or any media. So desktop deployment is all about using network cable to install Windows on a client system. So that's why, so during the installation of the client's operating system, you have to make sure that the client system should be given an IP address that is coming from the server. That's why we need to set up a DACP. Apart from that, the client system, we are going to deploy a operating system like Windows 8, Windows 10 on them. So before you can do that, you have to make sure that you have a media, that is a Windows OS. So you can start to go for Windows 8, Windows 10, any operating system you want to deploy on that client system is what you keep in mind. Windows Deployment Services, so WDS and DACP. Let's get into it then. Alright, so as usual, you've been able to install Active Directory and DNS, so we'll go ahead and click on Add Rules and Features, click on Next, go ahead, and then you can see it picks my domain name, that is my fully qualified domain name, which comprises of my computer name and my domain name, and then my IP address and the server that is running here. I'm going to click on Next. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'll check in DACP. I'm going to scroll down and then I'll check these Windows Deployment Services as well. So you can see Windows Deployment Services provides a simplified, secure means of rapidly and remotely deploying Windows operating system to your computer over the use of a network. As well as DACP, which stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, which enables you to centrally configure, manage and provide temporary IP address and related information to client computer. So that's what we're talking about. So I'm going to go ahead, so if possible, let's do it one after the other. So I'm going to go ahead and then install, only get the rule installed. So DACP, click on Next, click on Next as well, keep on clicking on Next, then install. That is easy. Remember, after the installation, you need to configure before it works. So we are just waiting. So you can see complete DACP configuration. So configuration is required. So I'm going to close it. Go ahead and click on Add. And then we go ahead and we add Windows Deployment Services as well. Then we configure them one after the other. So this same thing. Keep on clicking Next, Next, Next. And then install. So I'm going to close it out. So now you can see there are a lot of configuration that needs to be done whenever you see this warning symbol. So I'm going to click on Tools as usual. We look through DACP and I'm going to expand this. And you can see I have my service off and it's not running. So you can see the service is off. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to right click on my IP version 4 because I'm not working on IP version 6. So I don't go in there, I'm working with IP version 4. I need to configure my DACP server. So I'm going to right click on my server and then I'll create a scope. So in order to configure the server, the first thing that needs to be done is to create a scope. So I'm going to right click on IP version 4, then you select new scope. Then you click on Next, then you put in the name of your scope. I prefer to call it, you put any name of your choice, but make sure that the name is descriptive. I'm just going to call it DACP server. Going to click on Next and the starting IP, I'm going to put 192.168.0. Remember, we cannot use one, because we said that every device has to be what? Unique. An IP address simply states that a unique identity that is given to a device or a computer. Already one has been given to our server already, so we cannot use one. So any number or any digit apart from one, you can use it. So I'm going to start from two. So the first person who requests for an IP address for my network will receive two, and the last person is going to receive 192.168.0.50. So that means that it will be a range. So the first person will get 2, 3, 4, 5 all the way to what? 50. There's no way someone can get 50 while someone has not gotten 2. It's not possible. So it's a sequential manner. I'm going to leave the length, so that is the net, and that's my server mask. I'm going to click on next. I can decide to exclude an IP if I want to. So if I have addresses that are excluded, will not be given out to client community. So if I exclude 2, then 2 cannot be given out to client community. So let's exclude 2 and 3. So that means that the first person who requests one IP address should receive what? 1. Sorry, should receive 3. So 2 and 3 is going to be excluded. So it will start giving out addresses starting from 4. So let me click on next once again. Then I'm going to exclude 192.168.0.2. And then it will end 192.168.0.3. So 2 and 3 are excluded from the range. So I exclude. It says exclusion address that are not distributed by service. So this type of address range you want to exclude. So that's what you type in here, and I've excluded, and I'll just click on add and to be added. I can remove it if I want to. Click on add and it will be there. Then you can click on next. By default, when the DHCP server gives out IP address to the client computer, the default duration is 8 days. So in 8 days time, it's going to what? Expire. So DHCP server will revoke the address after 8 days. You can decide to increase it, we can reduce. So we have 8 days, we have in days, hours and minutes. So in 8 days, 0 hours, 0 minutes, he's going to what? Take back the address, or you're going to revoke the address he gave to you, and then you have to request for the address again, then to give you what? A new set of what? IP address. So that's what this one does. So you can decide to modify, or you can leave it by default. I'm going to click on next, and I need to configure. I'll say no, and I'm going to click on next, and then I'm click on finish. So let's configure it ourselves. So now that the scope has been created, you can see the scope and the name that I gave to the scope. So now I have to click on the scope, and you can see the address pool is the range of addresses, and those that are excluded are shown right here. We have address list. This is the point where anytime this server gives out an address to any client computer, that computer's name will be here, the IP address, duration that the address has been given, everything will be shown here. So if you have 1,000 computers, and those 1,000 computers receive an IP address from this server, they will all appear right here. We have this option to reserve. I can decide to reserve an IP address and make sure that. So reservation ensures that the client always is assigned the same IP address, even if the revocation day gets to. Remember we said that in 8 days time, the address will expire. But if I reserve, that means that in 8 days time, it will still give back the same address that was what? That was given to the client computer. So that's what this one is all about. So remember, in order to perform reservation, you have to make sure that you have the operating system up and running. The client system should have an operating system running on it. If not, you can't perform this, because you need is what? MAC address. So you have to give a name, and you provide the address you want to give out, and then the MAC address of that particular system. If not, it's not going to work. So that means that the system has to be up and running before we can get a MAC address of that particular system. So that is for the reservation. We are not going to add it. We're going to close it for now. So what we're going to do, the scope you can see is in red. So we have to go ahead and activate our scope. So right click on it, and then you click on activate so that the scope will be activated. So you can see it's activated. Let me right click on my server and refresh, and then you can see that now the scope is activated. All right, but still you can see that IP version 4 is still not running. So before it works, you have to activate, or we have to authorize DHCP server within what? Active directory. So I'm going to right click on it, then I'm going to authorize. So it has been authorized now. So now refresh the page, and you can see that now it's going to work for you. So this DC1 can use lamp local is really so now the DHCP server is configured and is working perfectly. So you can see the ranges that I gave, and then the exclusion, the address list we said will display all addresses that has a error. So that is how to configure the ACP server. So it is perfectly working. For a reason, you can decide to restart. If you encounter challenges, you can use this option. You can decide to restart the service. You can decide to pause the service. You can decide to stop. If you stop it, that means that it will not be able to continue giving out addresses as well as pause. And if you restart to, if your service is not working, you can decide to restart it. And it's going to put it off for a few minutes and it's going to come back on online by itself. So that is how it works. So that is that. So we are going to be testing these addresses that we have set up. We are going to, a client will be trying to contact this server to see if we will be able to get an IP address from it. So we deploy that one later on. So we'll be testing the ACP in the next set of videos upcoming. So I'm going to close it out. Then we go ahead to configure Windows Deployment Services as well. So I'm going to scroll down, then you can find Windows Deployment Services also right here. So expand your service, and then you can see that one also needs to be configured. It says that this server is not configured. To configure the service, right click on the server and click on configure server. You must be a local administrator. So if you are not the admin, you don't have administrative right, there is no way you can what perform this task. So make sure you are, and I am. So I'm going to right click, then I'm going to select what configure server, stick to default, click on next. I'm going to integrate with Active Directory because I have Active Directory domain service already what set up. That's why we started from what Active Directory domain services. If you don't have it, you can decide to go for the second option, but I have it, so I'm going to integrate it with what, so that authorization and everything will be taken care of by what Active Directory. So I'm going to click on next. Now it's advisable not to store the location on this same drive. So it's going to create a folder called remote install and it's going to drop it on drive C, but it's advisable not to drop it here. But for this lab, we prefer to store it on the same drive. So it's preferable not to create a different one media. So you can see I have only one hard drive, so let's confirm here. You can see I have only one drive, which is drive C. So I have to get another one media, let's say drive D or drive E, that will help me store this content on it. But for our case, we prefer to leave it as you see here. So I'm going to close this one out and then leave it. But it's going to warn us that this volume selected is also Windows system volume. That means that the container operating system, if something should happen, you lose it. So for best performance, they recommend that you do it on a separate volume, if possible on a different desk. But yes, so do you want to continue? Yes, I accept that whatever happens, I'm okay with it. I'm going to say yes. Then I'll leave everything as a default. I'm going to click on next. Now, if you leave it at do not respond to any client, so when a client try to contact the server, they will not be able to get an anything from where, from this server. So for that case, I'm going to go for what, respond to all client computers. I can decide to go for only known client computer, but I'll go for the last option. Then I have to approve before they can what perform any. And so this one, the administrator needs to approve the computer, whether known or unknown, before they can go ahead to get an address from that. That's called a PXC server initial what settings. So I'll leave it as you see. Then I'm going to click on next. Now, if it configures, it is going to give you an error that the server did not respond to the start or control request in a timely fashion. Don't worry about that. Just click on finish. Now the service is not running. So I have to do, just as you saw in Windows DHCP, you just have to right click on the server's name, go ahead to all tasks and start the service. Give it few minutes, you can see that service started successfully. And if I click out now, I can see that it's in green. Now it's perfectly working. So we have configured DHCP and then what? Windows Deployment Services. So in the next video, we are going to be adding some images to the Windows Deployment Services. We are going to be adding some boot images as well. And then we will test it on a client system to see if the client system will be able to install or deploy an operating system on the client system. So stay tuned for the next upcoming video. I hope this video was interactive and it was engaging as well as educative. See you in the next set of videos. Bye.